deals the cards to find the answer. The secret geometry of chance, the hidden law of a probable outcome, and the numbers lead a dance. I'll move at the space are the size of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know the diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. Now he may play that jack of diamonds, or he may lay that queen of spades. He may conceal a king in his hand while a memory of it fades. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know the diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape, the shape of my heart. I told you that I loved you, it made me think there's something wrong. I'm not a man of too many faces, and this mask I wear is one. But those who speak know nothing and find out true their cost, like those who curse their luck in too many places, and those in fear of loss. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know the diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape, the shape of my heart.
Had a lovely time, but Dinah and I really must be going. What is the best way out of here?
The child wanted to leave. Oh, no, no, no. That certainly wouldn't do. Using swift thinking, I pulled out two pills out of my pocket and offered them to Alice.
You take the purple pill, you awaken from your slumber, and the story ends. You take the green pill, you stay in Wonderland. I'll show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. The girl's eyes widened with wonderment again. I could tell I had caught her attention. She reached for the purple pill, and I sensed with panic, but she hesitated. She lingered there for a moment before finally taking the green pill.
Thank you.
24 seconds of Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, she took the path to the White Queen's palace. She began to confide in the White Queen, feeling comforted by a warm, caring nature.
Your Highness, I must confess, I get these awful feelings sometimes. Some days I feel so sad that I don't want to do anything. Other times I feel so anxious to the point where I can't seem to catch my breath. Oh, and sometimes I feel so insecure, so poorly of myself, that I wish I weren't me at all. On those days, I don't even want the company of my Dinah. And yet, I cannot express these feelings to anyone. So they simply sit there and don't go away.
The White Queen took Alice into an embrace and told her,
My dear child, you must not get into your own head. You've taken a step by acknowledging their presence. Your next step is learning how to overcome those dark emotions of yours. You're strong enough to work through them, and you have this land full of creatures willing to aid you in that process.
But I feel like I'm growing even more mad. I've been following this rabbit with a clock in its pocket. My Dinah has been running around with the cat who can disappear, and I've gone through so many changes that I've been taking advice from a caterpillar who doesn't even speak to me. Is that not absurd?
The queen shook her head.
Indeed, this place is mad, Alice, but we can only guide you in your journey. You must find the strength within yourself to climb out of that negative mindset. Think of it as playing a game of chess against a darker version of yourself. You can defeat her. Why, child, in this place, you could defeat the Red Queen if you wanted to.
There's no use in trying, Your Majesty. It's foolish to believe in the impossible.
I dare say you haven't had much practice. When I was your age, I always did it for a half hour a day. Why, sometimes I believed as many as 6 impossible things before breakfast.
I've been on the low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. I feel like my life ain't mine.
Who can relate?
Woo! I've been on the low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. I feel like my life ain't mine. I don't wanna be alive. They think they know it. I've been praying for somebody to send me. No one's heroic in my life. Don't even matter. I know it. I'm hurting deep down, but can't show it. I never had a place to call my own. I never had a home. Ain't nobody calling my phone. Where you been? Where you at? What's on your mind? They say every life precious, but nobody care about mine. I've been on the low. I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. I feel like my life ain't mine.
Who can relate?
Woo! I've been on the low. I've been taking.
daughter to the White Queen and left the palace. I sprinted to catch up with her. Where do you think you're going now?
I'm taking the White Queen's advice. I'm going to go see the Red Queen.
The statement alone nearly made me stop dead in my tracks. But I continue to follow her. Well, I suppose imagination is the only weapon in the war against reality.
I'm not afraid.
Yeah. It's been a ride. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you.
You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them, but you won't take the sting out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'ma let you stop me from causing mayhem. When I say I'ma do something, I do it. I don't give a damn what you think. I'm doing this for me. So the world feed beans. It's gassed up. If it thinks it's stopping me, I'ma be what I set out to be. Without a doubt, undoubtedly. And all those who look down on me, I'm tearing down your balcony. No way fans are bust, don't try to ask him why, how can he? From infinite down to the last relapse album, he still whether he's on salary, paid hourly, until he bows out or he just bows out of him. Whichever comes first, for better or worse, he's married to the game. Like a f*** you for Christmas, his gift is a curse. Forget the earth, he's got the earth to pull his f*** from the dirt and f*** the whole universe.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand.
I shouldn't have to rhyme these words in the rhythm for you to know it's a rap. You said you was king, you lied through your teeth. For that, your feelings, instead of getting crowned, you're getting capped. And to the fans, I'll never let you down again, I'm back. I promise to never go back on that promise. In fact, let's be honest, at last we laughed, CD was aired. Perhaps I ran them accents into the ground. Relax, I ain't going back to that now. All I'm trying to say is get back, click, clack, blow. Cause I ain't playing around, it's a game called circle. And I don't know how, I'm way too up to back down. But I think I'm still trying to figure this crap out. Thought I had it mapped out, but I guess I didn't. This f***ing black cloud still follows me around. But it's time to exercise these demons, these motherf***ers are doing jumping jacks now.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm,
to get clean. I did it for me. Admittedly, I probably did it subliminally for you, so I could come back a brand new me. You helped see me through, and don't even realize what you did. Cause believe me, you, I've been through the ringer, but they can do little to the middle finger. I think I got a tear in my eye. I feel like the king of my world. Haters connect like bees with no stingers and drop dead. No more beef flingers, no more drama from now on. I promise to focus solely on handling my responsibilities as a father, so I solemnly swear to always treat this roof like my daughters and raise it. You couldn't lift a single on it. Cause the way I feel, I'm strong enough to go to the club or the corner pub and lift the whole liquor counter up. Cause I'm raising the bar. I shoot for the moon, but I'm too busy gazing at stars. I feel amazing and I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, just let me know that you're not alone. Holler if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Why is it when I'm Alice that things seem to be more difficult? Alice has it much easier in the world. I do not like it one bit.
You seem unnerved by the wonders of the land. What is not to your liking compared to your quaint home society? Are you not content with the structure here, with the perfectly imperfect?
If I had a world of my own, everything would be nonsense. Nothing would be what it is, because everything would be what it isn't. On the contrary, what is, it wouldn't be. And what it wouldn't be, it would. You see?
Well then, you're in the right place. At that moment, the Dormouse walked by. It took note of Alice and scurried away quickly. Remembering of a cat, Dinah, Alice ran to catch her, but missed as the mouse slipped into a hole that Alice was far too big for now. She shook her head in silent frustration.
Would life not be easier if I were a mouse?
Well, sure. That is, if you want to run away from your problems all your life. But it seems as you already do.
And what do you mean to say with that, Mr. Rabbit?
Don't be a mouse, child. You were given a voice instead of a squeak. Speak up.
Yeah!
so much that I grew tired of trying to keep up with her. She exclaimed,
"Oh, how I love all these creatures I'm meeting. They're each so different in appearance and in spirit, and yet you all seem so accepting of one another."
I was puzzled. I inquired, "What do you mean by that? Is that not how your world is? But you all look the same. What's there to argue about?"
"Oh, heavens no. Where I come from, everyone fights about everything. There are fights over race, gender, sexuality, religion, politics, and worst of all, money. Ugh, it's so exhausting. I wish everyone would just agree to accept each other's differences, as all of you do down here."
"Oh, Alice, people are simply afraid of what they do not understand. I pity the poor girl. The world she describes seems so awful. Wonderland wasn't perfect by any means, especially with the Red Queen around. But Alice had a point. The creatures here did get along without judgment."
Thank you.
Cars are painting the roses?
Why, the fact is, you see, that it ought to have been a red rose tree, but they have planted a white one by mistake. If the queen were to find out, it would be off with their heads, as so often the queen orders when she's upset. She gasped in horror.
But that's so cruel. Why do people obey such a horrid woman?
We remained perfectly silent as we tensely entered the palace. The Red Queen greeted Alice with a sinister smile, immediately challenged her to a game of chess. After approximately 1 hour, 52 minutes, and 49 seconds, I could see that the child grew frustrated because of the queen's unfair and confusing methods of playing the game. How do you like the queen? I asked in a low voice.
Not at all. She's so extremely...
Just then, she noticed that the queen was close behind her, listening. So she went on...
Likely to win. That it's hardly worthwhile finishing the game. How may I possibly compete?
Bide my tongue, bide my time. You should see me in a crowd.
child had guts, I had to admit. But I became more and more worried that she would get hurt. She had no idea how powerful the Red Queen really was. All the new laws being implemented, the latest bill that passed that required all citizens of Wonderland to look according to certain standards. Alice surely will not fit the bill, no pun intended.
There's laws for one's appearance? That's absurd. What does that have to do with anything? The face is what one goes by, generally.
That's just what I complain of. The Red Queen wants everyone to conform to her liking. And you? Well, your face is the same as everyone else. The two eyes, so... nose in the middle, mouth under. It's always the same. Now if you had the two eyes on the same side of the nose, for instance, or the mouth at the top, that would be some help.
But then I would be ugly and weird. And then what would others think of me?
You seem to care far too much about what others think of you. No one has the face and form for everything.
Well then, what do you suppose I do?
Be yourself, of course. But don't let the Queen know that. It is not hard, dear child. So what if you look a little peculiar? Because you know how extravagant mine is, and high quality fur, such as my own. Everyone has their own special quirks. I answered, hoping that she would not notice that my ears are not white at all. Not white at all.
If everybody minded their own business, the world would go around a great deal faster than it does.
Students walked out of their schools today at 10 a.m., a 17-minute walkout.
We just want to end gun violence. We should come to school to learn and not to lose our lives.
I was still not convinced that Alice knew what she was up against. Many of us in Wonderland have been complaining about the certain laws the Queen seems to come up with on a daily basis. Nobody under the age of 2 should be able to buy a sword. Anyone more than a mile high may leave the courtroom. And a favorite, the slightest offense against the Red Queen results in decapitation.
Off with her head!
However, my thought process continued. Alice Alicia Alex might just be the one who will bring the Red Queen to fall. What if I lead her into a situation that will make her so mad, so against the Queen, that she ends her reign once and for all?
How long is forever?
Sometimes, just 1 second. Certainly not sure that I had done the right thing, putting Alice in such a dangerous situation. It was even too much for me. She did not know it was just a dream. Or was it? When I saw her again, she was sitting in my living room across none other than the Red Queen playing a game of chess. When I noticed that something in her had changed, I did not believe my eyes. Had that girl lost her marbles? Of course, I was curious to listen in on the conversation, but I could only hear bits and pieces.
And how many hours a day did you do lessons?
10 hours the first day, 9 the next, and so on.
What a curious plan.
That's the reason they're called lessons, because they lessen from day to day. But I dare say you've not had many lessons in manners yet.
Manners are not taught in lessons. Lessons teach you to do sums and things of that sort. But manners, on the other hand, one learns to treat all others with respect and to accept everyone as they are, no matter their shape or size. That's expected, especially from those in power. True leaders serve their subjects, not the other way around. They govern in a way that is just and fair, providing both equity and equality.
Child, it seems as though you're wanting to suggest something about the way I choose to govern. However, I know you wouldn't dare speak that way to me. I believe you're in need of a real lesson. I'll show you manners.
Possible moment to ask, the caterpillar appeared once more and finally spoke.
Who are you?
I hardly know, sir. Just at present. At least I know who I was when I got up this morning. But I think I must have been changed several times since then.
Sternly, the caterpillar asked,
What do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
I can't explain myself, I'm afraid, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
The disappointed caterpillar began to leave again, feeling as if he wasted his time. Oh, and how I hate wasting time! But before he could leave, Alice snapped at the caterpillar.
Enough! I've had enough of you watching me. judging me, and saying nothing. I've gone through all of Wonderland, changing in shape, size, color, gender, and that seems to satisfy none of you. So since you seem to know the answer, why don't you tell me? No more doors, no more potions, no more looking glass, no more Red Queen calling the shots. Who am I, Mr. Caterpillar?
I gave all my oxygen to people that could breathe. I gave away my money and now we don't even speak. I drove miles and miles, but would you do the same for me? Oh, honestly. I gave you all my energy and I took away your pain. Cause human beings are destined to radiate or drain. On what line do we stand upon? Cause from here it looks the same. And only scars remain. Life can get you down, so I just numb the way it feels. I'll drown it with a drink and out-of-date prescription pills. And all the ones that love me, they just left me on the shelf. No farewell. So before I save someone else, I've got to save myself. Life can get you down, so I just numb the way it feels. I'll drown it with a drink and out-of-date prescription pills. And all the ones that love me, they just left me on the shelf. Oh, farewell. So before I save someone else, I've got to save myself. And before I blame someone else, I've got to save myself. And before I love someone else, I've got to love myself.
I see you found the answer to my question.
The caterpillar remarked. The girl nodded.
I am Alice, and Alex, and Alicia. I'm all of them as they are all of me. And by embracing this, I will defeat the Red Queen. Watch and see.
The caterpillar responded.
You did not need me, nor anyone else in Wonderland to tell you. You simply needed to realize it yourself.
And with that, the caterpillar left. Ah, so wise, that caterpillar. Although I did tell him I had handled it, yet he still doubted me. No one ever listens to me. Maybe if I was a philosopher, they would. No, but I already said I wasn't. And so, Alice smiled and stood. She looked down at me, and I asked, Are you ready yet, Alice?
To win? Ready as I'll ever be, Mr. Rabbit.
Well, good. Because we're awfully late. And so, our heroine set forth to the giant chessboard, where the two queens awaited her arrival. The Red Queen stood proud and confident, doubting that Alice, after all she had been through, would be strong enough to defeat her. After all, she ruled with a heavy hand. She demanded order and control, and was notorious for her short temper. However, her foil, the White Queen, had faith in Alice, for she believed in the courage of the child. She was quite the opposite of her sister. She was much kinder than the Red Queen, and she ruled liberally instead of tyrannically. She believed in peace, and knew that Alice was the key in achieving that. Alice herself was not so sure. She generally gave herself very good advice, though she very seldom followed it. And sometimes she scolded herself so severely as to bring tears down her eyes. And once she remembered trying to box her own ears for having cheated herself in a game of chess she was playing against herself. For this curious child was very fond of pretending to be two people. If you play an endless game against yourself, you are literally playing yourself.
Truthfully, we're all pawns in this game of life. Nobody will win. You must learn how to play properly. Otherwise, you'll end up being used as a pawn.
But I'm not sure how to, or even if I can, win this game. I'm not even entirely sure I understand how to play chess.
It's moves and countermoves, my dear. Remember, everything you do here matters, just as you shape each dream you have. You've come this far. All that matter, it is now your move again.
You're right, Mr. Rabbit. But you know what?
What?
Check me.
Stockings down and all that jazz. Start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz. Shoes and all that jazz. I hear that Father Dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz. Hold on, hon, we got a bunny hug. I bought some aspirin, not a United drug, in case we shake apart and want a brand new start to do that jazz. And all that jazz.
Hot.
And all that jazz. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz. And all that jazz.
She's gonna shimmy till her garden's gray.
And all that jazz.
Her red a Parker girdle.
Her mother's bloody curdle. If she could hear her babies scream for all
that jazz.
Seconds, Alice emerged victorious from perhaps the most complicated game of chess ever to occur. Seething from her defeat, the Red Queen turned towards Alice, and after glaring at her for a moment like a wild beast, screamed,
"Off with her head! Off with her
nonsense!"
The Red Queen thought that the little girl must have had a lot of nerve to command her to shut up. To say she was insulted was an understatement.
"How dare you!"
the Red Queen spat.
"Actually, sister, she beat you fair and square. She has every right to decide the fate of Wonderland now. Well done, my champion."
"Why, thank you, Your Majesty. I couldn't have done it without your guidance, and Mr. Rabbit's, and the caterpillars, and all the little creatures. What are we to do now?"
Well, you are just as much a queen now as your opponent. What do you think we should do?"
"Oh, I know the answer to this one. I can do this. I've got it. I think we must celebrate. And no, not with another dreadful tea party. Off we go."
Elated, the creatures and characters of Wonderland proceeded down a final path, trailing the reluctant, crimson-faced queen, her fair and joyful sister, myself, the crazed hatter, the arguing twins, the overgrown caterpillar, the dormouse, the grinning cat, and the cat that can't teleport. At the head of the fray was Alice, cheerful as ever, and finally content with her character, finally feeling like she fulfilled the true purpose in such a grand, strange land.
Thank you.
awoke, time froze. Wonderland, it seemed, ceased to exist. There stood our heroine, confused, shocked, angry. It was a moment of reflection, and she became relieved. The girl took one great look at herself and her character, looking back at the adventure she'd completed and the lessons she'd learned. What was that lesson, you may ask? Well, for the first time in 18 hours, 49 minutes, and 16 seconds, Alice was completely at peace with herself and her multiple personas. She surveyed the crowd, and each character, frozen, saddened that things were over. She could finally go home, but she couldn't possibly take all the creatures with her. The family she'd grown to have in a short period of time were the most expensive quality. But then she realized that if she learned one thing from Wonderland, it's that even the impossible can be made possible. With a grin wide as the Cheshire Cat's, she and Dinah made their way through the crowd, bringing everyone back to life. Each character was unique and different, as was she. Each struggle, each taught, each learned. Perhaps the greatest gift Alice brought back from Wonderland was a fresh perspective, a new mindset. You see, every person place, thing, or thing is wonderful.
No matter who you are, or what journey you take, it is perfectly okay to fall down a rabbit hole. Because we always return to Wonderland.
To see.